While I'm doing things here, you see, I'm just uploading my 5 minute video from before, which was for what's his name? Altcore SC2. I hope this video helped you. What I did there, I have no idea really. But what, Dirk? What is that video about? Two things. One is look at this. I give it all away. I did, Dirk. They would not see it. They don't need to see it yet. So, if you want to install Chromium, and why do you want to install Chromium, Dirk? For my Synology station. Has something like a Synology web clipper, and that is for Synology Node Station. Look at this, that's my Node Station. Yeah, so that's my Node Station here. This is it, that's where I do my things. Work, notebooks, MPI driving. So here's lots of stuff. It's, Dirk, it looks like Evernote. Yes, it does, and I don't want to make too much advertisement for Synology, but I think if you use Evernote Professional, this is it to me, and it does everything I wanted to do, right? And it's, to me, it's free. It runs on my Synology disk station. There's no space limit because I've got 8 terabyte hard drives on it. Yeah, I'm running out of space there too, but not so quick in time. And I still have my FreeNAS boxes, which are updaters, you know, update. Miro Drive is something for security, yeah, data security. But an update is an update. So, no, a Miro RAID system is not a backup. You need to have a backup, just in case. And I might go into these things one day too, but all in good time, right? So, back, why do you need Chromium? Because in a moment, the Synology. Go click it away. So the Synology Web Clipper is only available for Chrome or Chromium, right? It should work on Chromium. So here's my Synology. I just downloaded that icon, right? So, however, having said all this, so now, you know, we slackers from Celix, lazy slackers, we go and open GSLAPT. Look at this. So, super and safe password. And then we say, no problem, I want Chromium. Chromium. Chrome. You see, spelling, one day I really will learn it. Chromium. Do I even wrong now? Just go in Chrome. Chroma print, Chroma notes, blip, 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 blip. No Chrome for me. Open Chrome. What the heck, Dirk? And then we say, as Celix users, not a big deal, Dirk showed us sorcery. Again, super secret password. Now we write Chromium. Chromium. And what is BSU? Chromium is a fast-paced arcade-style top-scrolling shooter. Shoot! That means we don't... Chromium-based web browser. Slimjet. Chromium-based web browser. I never installed it yet. One day I will. I think I have to have a look in it, into it, because since Mozilla is Mozilla, we have to look into more alternatives, right? But you might just say like, Dirk, but I don't want to have this Slimjet yet. I would like to have Chromium. So not a big deal. We are out of options, you might say. No, we're not really, guys. Okay, what you got to consider? SBO tools, and I will call this video SBO tools. I might have seen that on a video from Caddy the Spitter, that Rockstar, you know, it might, but just, you know, maybe Rockstars have to spit on the end of the video. What do I know? I'm just a normal guy, right? I'm not a tycoon like Das Gregor. I'm not a banker or security guy or hacker like Irish. I'm just a dude sitting in his basement in front of his computer and being totally happy having Celix running. While I'm actually using Calculate Linux for my daily needs, but I have to run Celix daily now for a while, otherwise I can't just judge it, right? In a VirtualBox install will give you nothing about the system. Here I can tell you, dang guys, it's snappy. I tell you that. So, but time management, guys, 5 minute videos, no longer than this. SBO tools. You got to search for it actually. So our viewer just go SBO tools and hope it shows up. GitHub pages. Duran. I said Duran. Yeah, because I'm uploading that video here for you guys. So yeah, here it is. You see that? So now you will say, what am I going to do with that? All you do is you scroll down. No, you're not scrolling down. You go to documentation, then you scroll down. And look at this, SBO check, SBO clean, SBO config. So what is important is you install it. You install it. So you download it here. Download tile, blah, blah, blah. You got it. I have it in my download folder. If you change to your download folder, I'm the lazy guy. So SBO tools, I'll call it rename. I just take the whole thing, right, like that. I'm the lazy guy. So if you would be in your download folder list, then you go install package space, and then you put that thing. I didn't use sudo because I didn't want it to start running. So you say sudo in front, and then you shoot it up, and it works. It installs it, no problem. Oh, but after that, you really should have to run again sudo, right? Sudo, you have to run it. Sudo and then sbo snap, and then you say fetch. That will actually read the database and everything, so that SBO's tools can actually work for you. There was lots of actually in one sentences, right? Actually, yeah. So you say fetch, and it goes brrr, you know, then you see the Das Gregor, lots of code running through the screen, and that's a good sign. That's absolutely a good sign. And then look what we have, SBO Insta. So now we couldn't find Chromium, right? So now we go SBO tools, no, SBO find. I wanted to find something. Find Chromium. SBO find Chromium. But we use sudo because it is a sudo thing, and it will complain if you don't do it right. Look at this, Slimjet. It's shown here too. Uh-huh. But we want to have this Chromium, right? So I'm not too sure if I will get this Chromium here. I should get this one and only that one, but I'm not trusting it. So I will see. I can't say if that is what I will get. So what I do is now SBO install this one here. Aborted. Of course it's aborted because it can't do it. I didn't do sudo. But now we want to do it. SBO install. And I just copied that thing, you know, to make sure I don't get the BSU thing. I don't want the game. I don't want the game yet. It's a good game, by the way. I played it. It's actually a good game. So now you shoot it up. Unable to locate user. So okay, here it goes. Now we have to go. It didn't work out the way I wanted it. That's life, right? I had that before. Oh, how did you give it away? Here, Ninja is a small build system with a focus on speed. Dirk download, blah, blah, blah. So, the SBO install Chromium. Ninja is a small build system with a focus on speed. It differs from other build systems into major respects. It is designed to have its input files generated by a higher level. Is that what we had here? Chromium BSU, Slimjet, gender, profile. I can't say. Proceed with Ninja. I'm not too sure. Because Ninja is not showing, right? Or is it shown here? Profile sync daemon. This could be it. A small build system with a focus on speed. I don't want a system focus on speed. I will just say no. It looks like Chromium has options. Would you like to set them? No. Proceed with Chromium. Yeah. Are you sure you wish? Yeah. I might have to still install Ninja then later. That could have been a dependency. But I was too afraid that I get tons of things installed I really didn't want to. We have installed. We will just see. Because that's the beauty here. For some reason, there is no double check. You can just install it again and it will just install it again. No question asked. It doesn't say, oh, you got it already in your system. Let's go from there. No, no, no. Oh, look at this, it's almost done. Processing. Oh. No, I don't want that either. Where's the terminal, Dirk? Here. So, yeah, so it's downloading in a moment. 3 megabits, look, megabytes, look at this, guys. That rocks. I had MTS before, which was a nightmare. Here was optical fiber for so long, but they were sleeping. It's an ISP. And they just didn't connect it. They rather give you very bad performance for good money. And this is what they do. And now they lose a few thousand customers because there's a new boy in block and a new company. And they do a good job. And I'm very happy with that. So you see that one is done. This video is called Celix 14.2 Create Launcher for Basilic. Install Xenolic Drive. Up. Drive. Why the how come up in there? Dep to the DGZ for Xenology. This station. We just call it convert, huh? Could be too long. Convert dep to DGZ. That it's too long already. Look at this. Now we wait a moment. Still too long. One word. I'll tell you, one guy, one day I really... Now it should work. Yeah. Basilic into... Oh, look what it's doing here. You see, for people like me, this is just white writing racing over a black screen, right? For Das Gregor, he says that it's soothing to him, and I believe it is, but trust me, one weird code and his hair and his neck goes up. Bing, he will know it. But for me, I'm depending on people like Das Gregor, you know, and the hacker Irish, so that they check the code that I'm safe, you know. They got to do that. Yeah, I think now I can upload this one here. Okay, publish. Let's see what it does, the video. I'm actually surprised that lots of people watch my videos. My hopes were that I help one person and that would already do the job. If I have one person, then I'm more than happy. And the whole work was worth it. Because that's what we do, right? When Das Gregor sits there in his... stops ruling his empire, the same like Irish, you know, the banker. And when he stops running his banking monopoly, he takes the time and sits down like Das Gregor and explains to us mortals how things get done. And this is it. Here, see, I just have an error here. Chromium might be there, but I have an error because I haven't installed. It's not even there. I haven't installed the dependency. I hope that is the only thing. So that takes their time. Yeah, now I want Ninja. The takes their time. Yeah. To show us how the things get done, you know, how the cookie crumbles with that Gen 2 kernel and... configuration, and I found it very intriguing, and I might have to install Gentoo just for these things. I'm afraid of Irish powers. I don't want to end up sitting in front of Gentoo with i3 black screen white dots running all over the place, and maybe if you're lucky you have a light gray wallpaper in the background which you can hardly see, and all key bounds, you know, with my memories. I might just press so many keys and don't get anywhere where I want to go. And then compiling, you know, this is compiling here. That can take forever. Like in Gentoo, I think Chromium takes quite some time in Gentoo. I mean, this is an old laptop, old PC. It's a quad-core AMD CPU. So it's not that super-duper machine. It has 16 gigabyte RAM. There you go, Das Gregor. I have the same RAM as you have. Ha! And that computer was my Voyager station running FreeNAS. And when I got the... I took all the USB sticks and drives and put it in my TARDIS case. So TARDIS is now in a moment Voyager, and Voyager is my testing computer here for you guys. And for me, of course. Totally not selfless. I'm doing it for me too. I do it for all of us. So, I hope I don't get an error now here, because the error is just, you know, why did you not say yes to Ninja? You know? It should do it now, and I should have Chromium running. And then I can test if I can get Synology Web Clipper running in Chromium. That would be nice, actually. What I'm looking for is, I know that's almost 5 minutes, this video, it has to come to an end. Failures. We do not tolerate failures. Yeah, I couldn't get Chromium here. Oh, now I'm sad. Gmod cannot operate a dangling. I can't do a dangling simling either. Oh, that's interesting. That's the first time SBO Tools doesn't get something installed properly. Yeah. There are different ways, guys. We never give up. That's the most important part. So, I can't test that yet. Time management. Chromium Opium for Slugger. So I have to keep that video a little bit shorter. Alien Slugware. Yeah, we could go for Google Chrome if we want to. Build. We go for the build. We look for the big numbers. Don't see any here. Package 64-bit, that's what we want actually. 14.2. Chromium TZ 56 megabytes. So that should it be. That's 63, so that's actually a very modern version here for us. I put that in download because it's not ready to go, I think. Maybe it is, I don't know. Yeah, we didn't get what we wanted, so boo-hoo. Call to do with USM returned exit status 1. I don't know, I might have had to reboot for the codex to work, which I installed. Could be that, I don't know. I know only we get now a much better Chromium. Instead of 53, we get a 63. That's pretty neat, isn't it? Dashboard. Yeah, here it is. Yay, the video is at least up, the first one. I'll put this one up too. And yeah, so if that video couldn't show you how it works, which is pretty sad. As I said, SBO Tools has never let me down. So I'm a little bit surprised to see that happening here. I might have to read through here too. I might have to check things. And there's a tool to manage SBO configs, SBO check, manage. So yeah, we work it out while on the fly while we go there, right? So we had Chromium. Sometimes you actually need the real thing, so you need Google Chrome. Let's see what that does. Enable plugins, okay. But that is from when? Register 2005, that's from 2009. So no, we don't want that. Let's see, Google Chrome should. Oh, guys. That they always hide the keyboard for people like me. Google Chrome. Chrome web browser. Download Chrome. 64-bit for Debian. So we would have to do the same off Fedora. You know, I use an RPM file this time. Accept an install. I didn't say install. I wanted it downloaded. That's not installing. So we just download it, and then we do the same what we did with the DEP file, with the RPM file. How's that? Look at this, I mean, yeah, that's a difference right here. That service seems to be pretty slow. So, doesn't matter. Google Chrome, where are you? Google Chrome's. I do the same thing as I always do. Look at this. So, quick open up. No. Downloads. RPM to DGZ. I get a message, an error message most likely, because I didn't sudo it. See, now if we did dep to TGZ, now we use RPM. So the Fedora packages, sudo RPM. Command not found. But I think we have it in gslept. So that is the normal user's way, right? You look for things, you want to install them, and sometimes they're just not there, but here. They're here, that's the easy one. This time we don't have to go and bother sorcery. Successfully installed. That's all what we wanted. Click it away. Now we can run it again. And look at this. Duran. It's doing something. It's doing something. There. Ooh, 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 ooh. Creating Slackware package. Look, that's where it will put it, right? It goes in they call it Etsy, I call it ETC. And they put in an opt, they put opt Google, blub, 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 all these things. It's all looking good, looking good. So, let's see where our Google TGZ is. There it is. And again, this time I just go it that way. It's either way, just copy the whole thing. Keep it easy and simple. So now we have to go sudo. Install package pkg, right? That's what I do. Space. I'll put that one in the middle. What? Look at this, what Dirk is doing. Duran. Verifying packages. We're speaking with our mom now. Package Google Chrome was installed. So now it takes maybe a little moment for it to show up. Here's Google Chrome. Access the internet. Make Google Chrome. No, I don't think so. Automatically. Oh, no way. So, you see, there's Google Chrome. It's not that we can't help each other or ourselves. Show home button. Yeah, show me the home button. New tab. No, show bookmarks button. Yes. Show home button. New tab. That sounds good. What we want is, that's for sure, continue where you left off. Right? That's what we want. And we want them for downloads. Auto manage, spell check, location. Yeah, you can let the location run. I think it is not a big deal. Once you have a Gmail account, you anyway X-rayed already. But at least they didn't lie, right? They said they're doing this and they're doing it. So that's okay. I can live with that. No reason to go in panic mode. I'm looking for the safe and tell me, you know, don't save it just somewhere. We use it, use for service, tap to help, blah, 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 yeah, prediction service. Oh, they have a crystal ball. Use a prediction service, automatic send some system information. No, good, you see, that switched off by default. Look at this, Mozilla. People can do that. Protect you and device from dangerous sites. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Automatic send usage statistic. No, they don't, you see. Send a do not track. Yeah, that's this, you know, people don't honor this. Use a web service to resolve spelling. I should have that. I think I have it because, you know, my spelling. Content set a clear browsing data, autofill setting, manage passwords, language, spell check, location to download. That's what I was looking for. So, job done, guys. Now, this is it. Import bookmark. So, I could go. Mozilla Firefox. I don't know if it recognizes most likely Basilix here as Firefox. But I don't want to do it now. So we got Chrome now here. I might have to download again, you see. If I go for Chrome, it might just show up after I reboot, yeah, that I got my icons here. This icon I just downloaded, can do the same for Chrome. Who cares? I can do it all on my own. But I want to show you another thing, and that I don't know if it works. You see, I have a red dot. Updates. Node station for desktop 2.10, blah, 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 ready to update. After you click the update button, the package will be restarted. What's new doesn't work. No application. I want an application. You know what we do? Oops. Basilisk. This one. Ran. Okay. Yeah, see, it works. So, what does it do? It supports precise search, which, yeah, if I could type, it can only do what I type, right? Support saving files by Control S. Fixed an issue where users might fail to log into NodeStation. Okay. So what we got to do is, we will just say update now and see what it does. Look, it's doing something. Come back. It did. Look, it works. So that's the good news for the Synology station, guys. Look at this green dot. It did it. It's updated. Up to date. So, wasn't that a nice test that we can say, you know what, guys? We installed Synology Node Station from dep file. Oh, now it crashed. That's not very nice. I think the update wasn't good. I think I pushed that update too much. We're still in downloads, aren't we? I'll go in Slackware. See that, because I can't do this, can't undo that update, right? So I just go in here again and install package. We don't use Google Chrome. And I just go again, choose my node station. See, that is a Tinker thingy here, but that's what you got to do sometimes. Verifying package, blah, blah, blah. Package description. So now it's overwriting the update, right? So now I just shoot it up again. It could also be that it just needs a reboot, but I can't tell you guys now. I would trust it needs a reboot. That's all there is. Sometimes it is that way. Okay, so that is a video which is partly success. A very partly success with our Chromium. I couldn't get Chromium. We got Google Chrome. And as I said, you see, like here, you don't have the icons and stuff like that. The Synology drive worked with the icon. I will see after reboot, and then I will have a look at this. So I cut this video here off. In my next video, I'll give you the success or non-success message. I hope that helped. You saw now that with what you can do with dep files, you can also do it with RPM files. And that's all there is. You can install Synology products on your Slackware. It works. And you know now SBO tools. And no kidding, guys. With Chromium, it has let me down the first and only time. But that could actually be because I haven't rebooted after the Codex install. I'll give it another try and then we will just see. Okay. This is it for now. My 5 minutes are over. I wish you all a good night and everything good. And I hope this video was helpful for people who are interested in Synology disk stations. You can make it work. It works just fine. It's good. So nothing to worry about it. And yeah, in the next video, I show you how Synology node station will work again. Otherwise, I will just have to uninstall it and take it out, right, and put a new one on. But I trust this is purely due to my update, and that's all there is. Okay, guys, wish you all the best. I hope you liked that video. Let me know. Subscribe, comment, encourage me. Okay, guys, I wish you all the best. See you soon. Bye-bye. Okay. This is part two. I will just put it on this 5 minute video I had already. Look what I did, guys. I downloaded OpenShot because I needed to add that video here on the first part. You will never know it was the second part. And yeah, you will. So I just downloaded OpenShot up image. That's what I don't understand. You know, why all snapper, all this stuff? You download OpenShot, you go right click, properties, permissions, say allow this file to run as program, then you double click on it, and look at this. That's what I was talking about in the beginning. Should a desktop file for home, Dirk, apps, blah, 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 app image be installed? You see desktop file. Okay, you say, yes, sir. And then you will see. in Multimedia. Open Shot. Duran. No, don't want that yet. So that's how I'm going to add. I have to actually convert, right? To make that video one piece. I didn't want to let you guys go because, as you see in the end, I wasn't too sure if that works with my note station, right? I mean, I was sure it works, and while I'm saying this, right, we tried to install sudo spo install chromium. How about we just give that a shot while I'm doing this here, because it doesn't take too long. Do we want it looks like Chromium has options. Nope. See, Ninja is already there. You have the option to use change instead of GCC in the build. Clang instead of GCC. Proceed with Chromium. Yeah. You sure you wish to continue? Yeah. So we let it run because I installed these code media codecs in the first part, right? And I believe that gave me some issues. Because Chromium could see it was about media stuff. The Google API keys provide in the Slack build are for this build is use only, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. So here it goes. See, for das Gregor, he can read that actually, everything in real time. He can tell you exact what every line is. For you and I, this is just, there's something flying over our terminal. For das Gregor, this is nothing. He just knows exactly every line. If he has a comma instead of a dot, he knows that right away. It gives him makes him uncomfortable, you know, otherwise it's soothing for him. And he might look like sleeping, but be aware. This guy knows everything. So if you have code questions, anything, just ask Das Gregor, he knows it. And on the other hand, the Irish, it's a hacker, he might just know too. Oh, my wife just texted, no, and the road, oh. One moment, I have to, this is, yeah. Oh, the spell checks have become worse, aren't they, guys? It's my really here. They became bad, right? Okay, so it's going now. So we have installed OpenShot. We just double clicked. It says, "Do you want to have a desktop file?" Yes, you do. And I showed in Calculate Linux how to create a desktop file, and that's how you do everything. I showed you guys, if you type in Synology, see the note station doesn't have the icon here. And I can't right-click and say properties to change it. There's nothing on this menu here either, property that allows me to go in the menu. Dang, but doesn't really matter. Here I cheated, right? I just made a shortcut here with my Synology note station, and here we go now. Look at this, look. And will it stay with us? Error, yeah, okay. So you see, we run the update and it's doing a fine job. See, no more red dot. We can go back here. Update, you see, it's all up to date. It's good now. So now we can use it without crashing. This was just due to my installing lots of stuff without getting everything done properly. See, Google Chrome is for some reason the same. It seems that in Celix, I have to try it in Slackware. I installed actually in Slackware Chromium. Might just be the build broken or something at SBO Tools. And Google Chrome doesn't have an icon here either. I have no idea why, but doesn't really matter. It's not a big deal. I will show in the desktop files how to do this, how to link to your icons. I did show this already in Calculate Linux, and it was about GNOME. Which nobody should use, have you ever seen their file manager? I was almost in a coma for 6 months when I saw that thing they call file manager. So go XFCE. No, I did not say i3. I said XFCE, and not Ranger. I used Thuna. KDE is like Arch, you know, if you like tinkering around and don't mind that every update something fails and something new gives you trouble, then I think KDE is great. I loved it when they had the first real stable version out from 5. Whatever. But then they called now everything stable, right? And no, guys, everything stable is not everything stable. Yeah, boohoo! It still didn't work. Now we know there's something wrong with the build, so we wait. Not a big deal, but we have Google Chrome now. We helped ourselves again. It's all working fine. OBS Studio we have now. OpenShot running here. See, that's what I recommended for Das Gregor. Because if you have trouble and you don't want to spend much time for troubleshooting, app image. Snapper stuff. Docker is okay. Docker, I like the idea of Docker a lot. But for people like you and I, the ordinaries, you know, we're not hacker like the Irish, or not a tycoon like Das Gregor. So we're just a few simple people who have stuff here like that. So we just use it. It works. It does a good job. You see, you have an app image, put it in your apps folder, double click, everything working fine. Perfect. Same happened with Etcher. It's an app image too. No snapper. Oh, you have to install snapper and learn some difficult commands, you know, and then I have to remember them, all of them. And no, thank you. I don't want that, right? Where is catfish? Here it is. So that, you see, that's a must have. So you see the great launcher. That's my memory, actually, catfish. I showed you that before, right? Check my videos about catfish. And so now I have to do all the hard work and task this together that you have a one part video. So that might now be 5 minutes, 30 seconds, 45. I still hope you like it. At least you could see that the station works. So you can install whatever you want from Synology Station in Slugware, even the latest drive, right? We did this. Look at this, don't forget, we installed, that's the latest thing, it just came out, I think, today or yesterday, Synology Drive. So what I got to do, Das Gregor, is I used the Cloud Station, and if you want to use Drive, Drive allows you to use their own office products. So you have your online office and all these little things, and you have something like OneDrive, Google Drive, Dropbox, whatsoever. So you have the whole Drive thing, right? And you can create your own folder thing. What I don't know yet, and I will figure this out because that will be interesting for everybody with Synology, do we have versioning like we had with Cloud Backup from Synology? I think it will work with that too, because that gives you versioning, and that is so great. And I show that in another video just to show it. I don't want to make special Synology videos yet. Do I like the products? Yeah, I'm very impressed, actually. But look at this here again. No icon. Dang-a-lang. I'll show you guys how to do this, but not tonight. Otherwise, this video will go more than 7 minutes, and not everybody has the time to hang around like I, you know. Okay, guys. Take care. Stay tuned. There's more coming. Trust me, I've got tons of ideas, but you see, a 7 minute video, now I have to compile it. That will take me another minute. Then I have to upload it, another 2 minutes. So it's lots of time going down. But that shows us as well, like when people like I or Das Gregor or the Irish sit there and explain things to us, they sacrifice their spare time for us people to learn and help us with our trouble and problems. And the motivation is, as you can see, that they don't have the advertising running, which that you see Josh all day long when you want to see a video, and then it's just getting interesting, then you see Josh again. No, you don't have that, because they and I, and I have the same idea. We would just want to give back to the community. I mean, I had received a lot from the community. It's my time to give back. And I won't switch on advertising, really not. I hope I can always work for my money and make my money the other way around. Quality-wise, one day I might buy a webcam. Don't know if you want to see me, then you just come and watch my videos for my looks. I don't want that really happening. And on the other hand, I will see. There will be equipment will be upgraded, because I think you guys deserve good videos. I can give it away a little bit that I'm not working with scripts in the moment, so I'm just making everything up the way it happens. But that's the way a user usually works with his computer, and that is what that channel is supposed to do. It's supposed to be the ordinary user sits on his computer and tries to do things, right? And that's what's coming out. And sometimes you get this hassle. You want to install Chromium, and no, you can't get Chromium because the the build is broken whatsoever. There are other ways to get it if you would really need it, but I'm patient. Well, I've got Google Chrome now, that will it do. Like, I use Google Chrome when you want to upload music to Google Music Play. I tried it with Chromium in a different build, and I think in Calculate Linux, and it didn't want to do it. So then I had to install Google Chrome, and it did it. So then you just use it, you know. It's okay doing it. And you have seen they have lots of their own spy functions switched off. I still have no understanding for companies spying on us, and I can't even understand that they go away for free. How is that possible? But what do I know? You know, that's the same when people say, we do this for you, the people. Yeah, if 78% say we disagree with what you're doing, who are the people? Well, but that's not my cup of tea, right? I'm not the one who makes this decision or lives these lives. I just sit here in my basement and play around with Celix. And I must say, I'm very impressed. Does it replace your Calculate Linux Turk? By no means, just like that. Because Calculate Linux is based on Gentoo. And, you know, rule 1-2. Das Gregor said Gentoo is king, and I confirmed that. And I can't just swap that around, you know, and say, no, it's Gentoo is king to me. In this means, you know, my king is actually Jesus, but I think I gave that away. But it is like Arch, except you don't have to fix everything all the time. Having said this, there's a video coming from Calculate Linux, which will help you to be prepared. You know, not like just Gregor, who almost murdered his Gentoo system with a new kernel. Luckily, he's really good with what he's doing, so he could resurrect it without any trouble, and he showed us how to do it so that even you and I can do it. But I want to show with Calculate Linux a much easier way, but that is coming up soon. Okay, guys, I hope you like that. What is that? Oh, that's my calendar. Yeah, I changed that a bit. Okay, guys, I hope you liked that video. Sorry that it took now almost 8 minutes, but this is the price to pay, but at least you know now what we installed. It works, and it was due to the reboot that it didn't work. Okay, so if you reinstall something and it seems to crash or do some funky stuff, just reboot the new system and the new installation, and you will be totally fine most of the time. Not always, but most of the time. You will be okay. Okay, guys, stay tuned, and I have to cut this off, otherwise it takes 9 minutes, and this is far too long then otherwise. Okay, guys, have a good night. Bye-bye.